Hey, Jonathan.
Hello. I'm a C2 quadriplegic. I can't move my hands. I can move my head.
I brought a cake for us and your caregivers today.
We all need to eat. And there is a community of people who need help eating. That's largely why I'm part of the research.
We are working on a robot-assisted feeding system, which we call ADA, A-D-A, which stands for the Assistive Dexterous Arm. The purpose of this project is to enable people with motor impairments to feed themselves using this robot arm.
I use a mouth-controlled mouse.
Over the last year, we've really been focusing on getting this robot to a state where it can be taken outside of the lab. Because at the end of the day, that's the goal of this, right? The goal of this is to enable people to feed themselves in the real environments they are eating in.
Very passionate about this.
Yes. 6 participants with motor impairments came to the university and ate a meal either in office, so like kind of a working lunch, or a conference room, so like a lunch meeting, or a public cafeteria. And then in September of last year, we brought the robot arm over to Jonathan's house, and from Monday through Friday, the robot fed him 2 meals a day in a variety of different contexts, so like eating while watching TV, eating while working, eating while socializing, eating in the kitchen versus eating in your living room versus eating in bed.
My task was I could think of possible ways to improve certain situations.
How's the face detection feel to you?
We found out, oh, the lighting here isn't good. It affected the facial recognition. When it does come at you, like, you flinch a little, like, is it gonna stop? And then they added some feedback controls, so that's good.
The perspective that, like, hey, it would be beneficial to have a version that could be mounted on a hospital table and just wheeled by a caregiver to wherever the user is, that's a perspective we got from Jonathan.
Curious how you'd see yourself using it in the future.
I mean, I'd really like to be able to eat alone at some point. I always need somebody to help me with things, and having a robot and being able to eat the way you want to, and when you want to. When you want to is a big one.
Doing this type of research where you're embedded in people's realistic context is the start, and now we'll improve it, we'll continue to have these deployments, and eventually then real people will be able to use it.